Good morning and welcome to today's International Space Station Update Hour. You're joining us here inside of the International Space Station Flight Control Room at the Johnson Space Center in Houston, Texas, where the Orbit 2 team is currently on console, monitoring all of the systems on board the orbiting laboratory. That team today is being led by Flight Director Heather Rarick. Joining her at the Capcom position to the left is Kathy Bolt, serving as the voice communication link between controllers here on the ground and the astronauts up in space. And those astronauts right now are the Expedition 30 crew, being led by NASA astronaut Dan Burbank there in the front left row. And behind him are Russian cosmonauts Anton Shkaplerov and Anatoly Ivanishin. Moving further across the back row, we have European Space Agency astronaut Andrei Kuipers, NASA astronaut Don Pettit, and in the front right, a third Russian cosmonaut, Oleg Kononenko. So the crew on board jumping into quite a few activities for the week, starting off with Commander Burbank, who's doing some preparation work for his upcoming undocking and landing. He will be working with Anton Shkaplerov and Anatoly Ivanishin to conduct some leak checks and other tests on their Russian Sokol launch and entry suits, which they will wear while they depart the International Space Station and land in their Soyuz TMA-22 spacecraft. That all set up to take place on April 27th, just under 2 weeks from now. Aside from those leak checks and tests, Commander Burbank is doing some maintenance work on the water recovery system, hooking up a transfer pump to transfer some fluid from the wastewater bus. And we'll also be preparing some items in one of the express racks, specifically something called DECLIC, or the Device for the Study of Critical Liquids and Crystallization. So he'll be relocating that from one express rack to another. Meanwhile, Anton Shkaplerov, the commander of that Soyuz TMA-22 vehicle, will be involved in those Sokol launch and entry suit checks, and also doing some other preparation work for their upcoming return to Earth, again, that coming up on April 27th. Aside from getting those suits ready, he'll be working in the Soyuz vehicle, hooking up a cooler and dryer, and also doing some fan cleanings in the Poisk module. And then while he's doing all of those, Anatoly Ivanishin, the third member of that Soyuz crew that'll be returning to Earth, will be doing some fan screen cleanings of his own in the Rosviet module, and also will be laying out the Sokol entry suits and all of the astronaut gloves for drying and cooling, and then eventually stowing those away once that's all completed. Our third Russian cosmonaut, Oleg Kononenko, who will become the commander of the International Space Station following the departure of current Expedition 30 Commander Burbank, is doing some pretty routine work over on the Russian segment, transferring some waste fluids and urine over to the currently docked Progress 46 spacecraft, which will be undocking a little bit later this week, and then eventually burning up in the atmosphere upon re-entry. He'll also be involved in a Russian experiment a little bit later today known as Yurigan. We'll be doing some Earth observations and taking photography. And all of this is done in the hopes of better using the International Space Station as an outpost for both monitoring and predicting any potential hazards and catastrophes down here on Earth, both man-made and natural. And then moving on, Andrei Kuipers is very busy today working alongside Don Pettit, doing some onboard training with the for the upcoming SpaceX launch. He'll be working alongside Pettit, rehearsing some rendezvous and grapple with the Canada 2 arm, working out some procedures while they're at the Kupola Robotics workstation. That Dragon spacecraft currently scheduled to launch at the end of April and then aiming for a rendezvous with the International Space Station on May 3rd will be berthed to the Earth-facing port of the Harmony module, and that will be the first commercial resupply cargo vehicle in order to bring resupplies back up to the International Space Station, again, currently targeted to dock on May 3rd. So Kuipers will be doing quite a bit of training for that today, making sure he's familiarized with all of the necessary robotic work, and he'll be working alongside NASA astronaut Don Pettit. Aside from that SpaceX training, Don Pettit and Kuipers will also be involved in the Space Sound Experiment, which is a Japanese experiment which uses a metallic bowl-like object and a stick generating kind of a constant buzzing noise that's then recorded with 3D microphones, and then whichever crew member is not actively making the sound, Japanese investigation into how sound is traveling and received while on board the International Space Station. And aside from that, Pettit will also be setting up the super-sensitive HDTV camera inside of the cupola to capture some of that more fantastic aurora views that we get during all of the nighttime passes for the International Space Station.